Obviously, this is an original IP. So what was it like coming from Mechanicus, starting to work on IXION?
Mechanicus was more about respecting the product in itself and trying to understand what's working in it, what we wanted to bring forward, and what we thought was not important. Here it's more about the full creative process. It's almost frightening to begin with a blank page and not to know what you want to do. We spent a lot of time talking with the team what we wanted to do at first and to put constraints on the design. We started with the main constraint of being in a station in space. It's interesting because at the very start of the project, we were not sure about what we were gonna do for a station. I think that's one of the elements of the game that went through the most iteration. We wanted to do a spaceship that could almost be done today, like with the current technology we have.
It has to look functional.
Even if it's not,
it's really easy to find really highly detailed references about how to make something that looks functional, even if we are not engineers.
We really wanted to push to have a nice station and space you can look at and see your space station traveling and not just having it like a teleport from a place to each other. It's almost completely useless in terms of gameplay. Like if you think about gameplay, you could have only the inside view and the solar system.
Yeah.
We try to brainstorm together at first, and it's not only like the concept artist does everything. We iterate on the concept art in itself, but the iteration continues with the rest of the process. Well, Arthur adds a lot of detail and things and complements the design and makes it even better.
This is not one person's vision. This is basically a lot of talents collecting ideas. When you put an asset in a game, maybe the concept art will not anticipate a lot of constraints and problems. There's a lot of blind spots, there's a lot of details that can not manage to be put in game.
Everyone has its own specialty. You have to do a little bit of everything. You cannot stay only inside your specialization. It's quite interesting to just bounce between different tasks and different things. It's quite fun. One thing I like is that we had a very hard sci-fi vision for the game. One of the goals is to have something very close to what's real and that we know of today. Throughout the journey, we go more and more into the strange. We stay within a very hard sci-fi core on a lot of elements, but we try to have different elements, different plays, different stories that could surprise the player when they see them. I think there is something we wanted to say with the game, that living in space is a very dangerous place for human beings. There is still a very utopical thinking about space, that we can just send something in space and we will survive, and we can do anything in space. You can pollute all you want because there is infinite room, but
there's no spare planet.
we only have one planet.
No, but that's good though. It's true, and I think that's that's what IXION is. It is fragility and it is danger, and sandbites aside.
Yeah.
But it is,
yeah.
And you know, when you're there in chapter 4 and chapter 5 without spoiling anything, and things are like on a knife edge between success or failure, and you're searching for this new planet to put your survivors on, it does feel incredibly fragile and incredibly like you're moments away from just complete disaster.
It's really informed the design of everything we did and the Tiqqun station, because it's something we wanted to show in the game, like the fragility of human construction in space. Like you can just put a hole in the station and everyone dies instantly.
So we had the Steam Next Festival earlier this year. What's it like seeing you know, your creations that you've drawn or modeled go out into the world and people then enjoy them. What's that like for you as an artist?
When I'm working on an asset, I will submit it to Lucas, and I know Lucas. I know what he wants, I know what I want, and then you have to push it online or somewhere. This is basically, to me, one of the most exciting part and a bit stressful as well. We're like, okay, people seems to be liking it, but yeah, this is totally,
you don't know,
yeah. This was a bit stressful. I needed to know if it was a good work or a kind of a validation.
It was quite nice to see people respond positively to it and yeah, resonate with the concept of the game. I think in the production process we have high standards about our own work, so I'm happy that people find it cool because
you're so focused on like the process.
We spend all day like saying yeah, this does not work, this needs to move, and in the end it's cool to make the idea of space travel into a game that people resonate with.